Hi, hello, good morning students. Till the last class we have completed 6 chapters explanation. Today I am going to introduce a new chapter, that is separation of substances. Students, separation of substances in the sense they are mixed together. Okay, two or more than two substances are mixed together. So we have to separate them. The meaning in the name itself, you can see the name of the lesson itself, you can see there. What? Separation of substances. See here, students. Separation of substances. So some of the substances are mixed together. Okay? Two or more than two substances, or two or more than two materials, like, you know, rice and other paddy grains, and rice and other dal grains, like that, you know, different, not only grains, you can take as many as possible substances or materials. If they are mixed together, then we call it as what? Mixtures. You know, if two or more than substances are mixed together, then we call them as mixtures. Okay, not only the solid materials, you can take liquid materials as well. You can take water and milk, and water and salt, and water and sugar, you know. So like, and solid and liquid substances are also present mixed together. Okay, they are also called as mixtures, right? And we have to separate them. How do we separate them? How do we separate? By following methods of separation. You know, what are the methods followed to separate the mixtures? You know, what are the methods followed to separate the substances from the mixtures? For example, you take the list of the methods given here. List of methods of separation here. First, hand picking, winnowing, sieving, filtration, distillation, sublimation, chromatography, separation. Sorry, till here only. Separation using more than one method. You know, till here, the different methods that we follow to separate the substances from a mixture. Okay, mixture in the sense, you know, two or more than two substances are present together. Okay, that is called mixture, right? Let us talk about hand picking. Hand picking in the sense, you can easily understand by looking at the word. You know, meaning in the word itself, you can see that hand picking. You know, by using our hands, we have to pick the substances. We have to separate the substances using our hands. Okay, can you give some examples for this method, hand picking method? Yeah, I think you might have seen your mother cooking rice. Before cooking rice, you know, your mother takes rice in a hand pan, you know. Meanwhile, your mother follows, you know, this process to separate some unnecessary or unwanted stones, if any, or unwanted mud rocks, if any, or unwanted that you know, that weed grains also present in the rice, right? And even sometimes, you see, even paddy grains are also present in the rice. Before cooking, your mother keenly observes the rice and picks them out. Okay, picks them and separates them and throws away, right? So this process is called, it's a very simple process, and in every household, every mother follows this method, separation of substances method. What is that? Hand picking method. It's a very easy method. And then winnowing method. What is winnowing? You might have seen during the season, the farmers harvest their paddy crop. After they harvest this paddy crop, you know what do they do? They keep that all cut plants at a particular place, and they separate the grains from the grass, that cut plants. Okay? And after they separate the grains, there may also present lightweight husk as well. Okay? To separate the husk and the heavy grains, not only grains present there, in the process of getting these grains, separating these grains, there may be, there may be a chance of rocks, stones, mud stones, rock stones, etc. along with the husk. You know, here one thing, in the process, winnowing process, here the basic principle of this separation method is the heaviness of the substances, the main role of separation of this mixture. The heaviness, you know, if you take after the grains are separated from the plant, there may be husk, mud, rocks, stones and other unwanted grains present in it. They are separated by taking the mixture of all these grains and the mud, rocks and stones in the pan and standing on a little high place and dropping the mixture using a winnowing pan, you know, dropping like this, and see there you have to make sure when you have to drop the mixture, when wind blows. When wind blows, you know, you have to drop this mixture from a little height. So when wind is blowing across, the dropping of this mixture, the lightweight mixture present in this, lightweight substances present in this mixture are carried away through the wind. Okay? The wind carries the lightweight substances away from these heavy substances. You know, heavy substances like grains fall in a particular place and become a heap, and even including grains there, the heavy substances like stones also present, mud, rocks also present. Okay, so these are the other substances separated by following other methods, and that lightweight husk is separated by following what? Winnowing method, when wind blows through the dropping path of this mixture. Okay, next let us talk about sieving. You know, sieving is also one of the separation processes, separating substances methods. You can see that after, you know, your mother cooks, you know, flour cookies, you know, some snacks using some flour, what does your mother do? You take a sieve and take the powder in the sieve and move here and there like the shake like this, and that powder drops down through the sieve, right? And if any grains or if any worms also, sometimes we see in atta flour, you know, sometimes it is with some worms in it, right? Sieving process is followed to separate these worms even. Okay, sieving method is done by using a sieve. Next, filtration. It's very common method in every households. You know, if we are preparing a tea or coffee, you know, you might have seen after the tea leaves or coffee powder or tea powder is boiled in the milk or in the water, a filter is taken and filtered. You know, if that, you know, powder, the remains in the filter, that pure liquid comes out through the filter, and that is collected in other glasses, right? So this process is called filtration. Okay, you just think about other substances which are separated by following filtration method. Okay, I'm giving you one or two examples, but you just think about more than the examples that I'm giving now. Okay, now let us talk about distillation process. What is distillation process, you know, students? It's a process of boiling water and collecting the vapor and making the vapor condensed and again collecting the water from the vapor. Okay, so here distillation process includes two other methods. What are they? First, evaporation and condensation. Students, here if any mixture like liquids, if any liquids are mixed together, liquid mixtures are separated by distillation method. You know, that liquid is evaporated first, that vapor is collected and condensed. After that vapor is condensed, that condensed vapor becomes water again, then that water is collected, that water is called distillate or distilled water. We collect what? Distillate or distilled water or distilled water. Okay, so distilled water is a form of pure water. No other salts, no other minerals, no other any substances present in that water. Okay, yeah, to separate salts or to get if the water is mixed with sugar, salt or any other substances or dissolved substances present in water, they are separated by following distillation process. We get pure water. Okay, to get pure water, this water is used in different purposes, like in batteries, that's different story that you will study in your higher classes. Okay, next, what is sublimation? Sublimation is also one of the methods of separation processes. Okay, it's a process of separating, in a sublimation process, making like you take camphor, take example camphor. Here in this camphor, when it is heated, what happens? Camphor directly, what is the state of camphor? State of camphor is solid. Once it is heated, what happens? The solid, after solid, what state should come? Once the solid is heated, that should come into liquid, right? But the property of camphor is, when it is heated, that solid camphor will not change into liquid, that directly changes into vapor. Okay, this process is called sublimation. Students, if any camphor is mixed with any other substances, in this heating process, that camphor gets vaporized and then other substances will remain without becoming vapor. Like this, you can follow this method, sublimation process, and you can separate the substances. Okay, students? And it's also one of the methods of separation. This process is called chromatography. What is chromatography? Chromatography is a process by which we can separate the colors from a particular color. Usually we see different colors around us, right? It's most interesting thing and it's very beautiful thing in the nature that we can see different colors. And do you think the color is that which we see is that only the particular color? Is not its own color, it's a mixture of different colors. Okay, students, here if you want to understand this, here what you have to do, you have to separate the colors from a single particular color. To understand this chromatography process, you have to take some green leaves. Green leaves, and you have to crush them and collect some extraction. After you crush green leaves, you get some juicy liquid part, right? That is called extraction. Yeah, this extraction looks in green color. Green color. But do you think green color is its own green color, only green? No, it's a mixture of different colors. Okay, green is a color, but it's not only green, it's a mixture of different other colors. Okay, so how do you separate different colors? How do you see the other colors present in the green color? You take a piece of chalk like this. Take a piece of chalk like this. And take extraction from the green leaves in a cup like this. What I wanted to put the cup like this. Yeah. Take the color, mixture of green color, like, you know, that extraction of green leaves here in this cup, and put one end of the. If you want to add some water to it, you can add. You have to dilute it first of all. Add some water. If you want to add some water and put one end of the chalk in the mixture like this. You know, you have to take the mixture here, no? Add some water to that and make it diluted, and take the chalk piece and one end of the chalk you have to put in the mixture, and after some time you see that absorption takes place. You know, chalk piece absorbs. What? Chalk piece. Absorption. Okay, here absorption takes place. In the process, what will happen? The color is separated in the process of absorption. You know, you can see different other colors. You know, blue you can see, dark you can see, blue color you can see, dark color you can see, and other pink color you can see, and orange color you can see. Different other colors you can see once, you know, the liquid, that mixture is being absorbed by this chalk. Okay, students? So, then you can understand the extraction of green from green leaves. It's a mixture of different colors. You know, a chromatography process is followed to separate the colors from a particular color. You know, the color that we see around us is not only that particular color, it's a mixture of different colors that we have to understand. Okay? And the chromatography is the process to separate different colors, students. Okay, next, chromatography is done. And what next? Yeah, separation using different methods. Separation using different methods. You know, students, if any different substances are mixed together, you can follow different methods of separation. Okay, students, and other methods are also there that are not mentioned here, like, you know, sedimentation, and decantation, okay. See, what is sedimentation? If any mixture is with liquid and solid, if heavy solid particles are settled at the bottom and that liquid portion is separated from this settled heavy particles from that liquid, and this process is called sedimentation. After sedimentation is done, that liquid portion is formed, is collected by taking, you know, by separating the liquid portion into another beaker, that is called decantation. Okay, so these are the methods that we follow to separate substances from a mixture. Okay, if you go through the textbook, you will understand in detail all about these methods of separation processes. Students, I hope you all understood this chapter.